Hello friends, today let's look at the Huffman coding algorithm. The Huffman coding algorithm is a lossless data compression algorithm. In lossless data compression, the original data can be perfectly reconstructed from the compressed data. In other words, in lossless data compression, there is no loss of the original data. Huffman coding algorithm is developed by David Huffman in 1952. While he was a Ph.D. student at MIT. This algorithm is widely used in mainstream compression formats such as JPEG, PNG, MP3, etc. Now before jumping onto the Huffman coding algorithm, let's first take a look at a simple data compression algorithm where we'll be using fixed length encoding for representing each symbol in the given input. Once we understand this simple data compression algorithm, will be in a better position to appreciate the Huffman coding algorithm. So let's take a look at this algorithm. Let's say we want to compress this particular text. Hi there, where are we? So let's find out the unique symbols in this text. The unique symbols are H, right? H, then I, then T, H is already included. Then E, right? There are six numbers of E's here. Then R is there. R. Then there is a W. Then the character A is also there. The symbol A is also there. And finally, space characters are there. Note that between the words hi, there, where, are, we, there are four space characters. So I am representing space here, space, right? So overall, there are 8 number of unique symbols in the given input. The unique symbols are A, E, H, I, R, T, W, space, right? Now because there are only 8 unique symbols in the given input, we can uniquely represent each symbol by making use of 3 bits. So I can use following encoding scheme where A would be represented by this bit sequence of 000, then E would be represented by 001 and so on. The last character space would be represented by 111. Note that each symbol is represented by fixed length encoding. The fixed length is 3 in this case, right? The frequency column in this particular table indicates as to how many times a particular symbol has appeared in the given input. So symbol A appears only once, therefore its frequency is 1. Then symbol E appears 6 times, right? Therefore its frequency is 6 and so on. So using this fixed length encoding scheme, the input text would be represented by bit stream, which is something similar to this sequence. The first 3 bits 010 represent the character H. Then the next 3 bits 011 represent the character I, and next 3 bits represent character space and so on. So what would be the length of this particular bit stream? Note that each symbol is represented by 3 bits and in the input sequence there are total 21 symbols, right? Therefore, the length of this particular bit stream would be 63 bits. The length of input text is 21 symbols and each symbol is represented by 3 bits. Now let's use the Huffman coding algorithm for compressing the same input and let's see how it minimizes the length of bit stream. So in the Huffman coding algorithm, we'll be using the same input. This frequency table represents the frequency of each symbol in the input. The first step of Huffman coding algorithm is that we sort the given symbols according to their frequency. So this frequency table would be changed to this table, right? Note that the symbols are same, but they are sorted according to their frequency. So symbol A has the least frequency of 1 and symbol E has the most frequency of 6. Because symbol E occurs 6 times in the given input, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, its frequency is 6. So the first step of sorting the given symbols according to their frequency is complete now. Now what we do is, we create a binary tree using following steps. Step 2 is, from the frequency table, we select two symbols S1 and S2 with least frequencies, say F1 and F2. In this case, S1 would be symbol A and S2 would be symbol I, because these are two symbols with least frequencies. And then we create nodes for S1 and S2. So we select symbol A, then we create a corresponding node for symbol A, then we select symbol I and we also create its corresponding node. Okay, now in the next step, we combine S1 and S2 to create a new symbol S12 with frequency as F1 plus F2 and we create its corresponding node S12. So S1 is A, S2 is I. We combine S1 and S2 to create a new symbol S12. So we combine node A and node I to create node AI with frequency as F1 plus F2, 1 plus 1, 2. Now the execution of step 3 is complete. In the next step, what we do is, we remove symbols S1 and S2 and we insert symbol S12 into the frequency table while keeping the table sorted. So we need to remove symbol A and we also need to remove symbol I from the frequency table. At the same time, we need to insert the symbol S12. In this case, S12 is symbol AI. So we need to insert symbol AI into the frequency table. Note that while doing all of this, we need to keep the table sorted. So after step 4, the modified table would be this. Note that the symbol A is removed, symbol I is removed, and symbol AI is inserted. This particular table is also sorted according to the frequency. Okay, now in the next step, we repeat steps 2 to 4 until there is only one symbol left in the frequency table. Step 2 is, we select symbol S1 and S2 from the frequency table with minimum frequencies. In this case, S1 would be symbol T, S2 would be symbol W. So S1 is selected, its corresponding node is created. S2 is selected, its corresponding node is created. Now step 3 is, we combine S1 and S2 to create symbol S12. So we combine T and W to create symbol TW and the corresponding node is also created. In step number 4, we remove symbol T and W from the frequency table and we insert symbol TW in the frequency table. While doing this, we need to keep the frequency table sorted. So, the frequency table after step 4 would be modified to this. Symbols T and W are removed and symbol TW is inserted. This frequency table is also sorted. Now, because there are more than one number of symbols in the frequency table, we need to repeat step number 2, 3 and 4. In the next iteration, symbol S1 would be symbol AI. So symbol AI node is already there. Then the S2 symbol would be symbol TW, right? Its corresponding node is already there. So this is corresponding node. Then we combine AI and TW to create a new node AITW with frequency as 2 plus 3, right? Because F1 is 2, F2 is 3. So new symbol's frequency would be 2 plus 3. Now in the next step, we need to remove symbol AI and TW from the frequency table and we need to insert this newly created symbol into the frequency table. So symbol AI and TW are removed and symbol AITW is inserted. Now in the next iteration of this algorithm, symbol H is selected as S1, its corresponding node is created. Then symbol R is selected as S2, its corresponding node is created. Both these symbols are combined to create a new symbol HR with frequency as 3 plus 3, right? Its corresponding node is created. And finally, we remove symbol H, symbol R from the frequency table and insert this new HR symbol into the table. The modified frequency table would be this table. Note that this is sorted according to the frequencies. Now in the next iteration of this algorithm, the two symbols with least frequencies are symbol space and symbol AITW. So S1 is symbol space, its corresponding node is created. S2 is symbol AITW, so S2 is selected. Its corresponding node already exists, right? We combine these two symbols to create a new symbol space AITW with frequency as 4 plus 5, right? And finally, we remove symbol space and AITW from the frequency table and we insert this new symbol into the frequency table. Now in the next iteration of this algorithm, S1 is symbol E, S2 is symbol HR. So S1 is selected, its corresponding node is created. So the corresponding node for S1 is this particular node. Then S2 is selected. We can see that the corresponding node for symbol HR already exists. So its corresponding node is this particular node. Then we combine symbol HR with symbol E to create a new symbol HRE. Its frequency would be 6 plus 6, right? Now we remove symbol S1 and S2 from the frequency table and we insert this newly created symbol into the frequency table. At this point of time, there are only two symbols left in the frequency table. So S1 is selected. Its corresponding symbol already exists. Then S2 is selected. Its corresponding symbol also exists. We combine S1 and S2 to create a new symbol S12 with frequency as F1 plus F2. F1 in this case is 9, F2 is 12. So the new frequency is 21. Finally, we remove S1 and S2 from the frequency table and we insert S12 into the frequency table. So the modified frequency table would be this table, right? Now at this point, there is only one symbol left in the frequency table. So we say that the stage 1 of this algorithm is complete. In the stage 1, we have created the binary tree. Now in the stage 2 of this algorithm, we assign value of 0 to every left branch and value of 1 to every right branch in this binary tree. So value of 0 is assigned to every left branch and value of 1 is assigned to every right branch. Now after assigning values of 0s and 1s, the next step is to traverse from the root node to every leaf node to get the Huffman codes. Now consider this leaf node. So this leaf node represents symbol space, and if we traverse from the root node to this leaf node, the first symbol seen is 0. So the first symbol seen is 0. The next symbol seen is also 0, right? And now we have reached this leaf node which represents symbol space. Therefore, the Huffman code for space would be 00. Now if you consider this leaf node, it represents symbol A. So this particular leaf node represents symbol A. If we traverse from the root node to this leaf node, the sequence of bits seen would be 0, 1, 0 and 0, right? So 0, 1, 0, 0. The Huffman code for symbol A would be 0, 1, 0, 0. In similar manner, we can obtain the Huffman codes for other symbols. So all the Huffman codes for the input symbols are shown here. Space is represented by 0, 0, right? And then A is represented by 0, 1, 0, 0 and so on. Okay, now let's see how many bits are needed to represent the input text when we use the Huffman codes. In Huffman coding, Symbol space is represented by 0, 0. Its frequency is 4. For symbol A, its frequency is 1 and 4 bits are needed to represent it in the Huffman coding. Now if you look at symbol E, its frequency is 6 and only 2 bits are needed to represent it. In general, what this algorithm tries to do is, symbols which are more common are encoded using fewer bits than less common symbols. So symbol space and E are more common and therefore they are encoded using only 2 bits, whereas symbol A, I, T are less common and therefore it can afford to use 4 bits to represent them. So this is basically a variable length encoding scheme, right? Now let's calculate the total number of bits used for representing this particular input. The total number of bits used are 2 into 4. So length of encoding is 2 and its frequency is 4. So 2 into 4, then 4 into 1, right? For symbol A, encoding scheme takes 4 bits and its frequency is 1. So 4 into 1 and so on and so forth until 2 into 6. For symbol E, its encoding takes 2 bits and its frequency is 6. If you calculate this particular sum, it comes out to be 58. The total number of bits needed for representing this particular input is 58. Now note that 58 is less than the total number of bits used in fixed length encoding scheme. If you remember, in the fixed length encoding scheme, we needed 63 bits for representing the same input, right? This is basically the fixed length encoding scheme, whereas the Huffman coding scheme is variable length encoding scheme. Okay, now you must be thinking that after performing so many operations, there is saving of only 5 bits, right? But note that the real world inputs are much more lengthier than this particular input and the savings turn out to be really significant. I hope that the algorithm is clear now. We are going to continue with the Huffman coding series in the next video, where we are going to cover the implementation of this algorithm. To get the updates for our videos, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you and cheers.